गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन, आई एम प्रियंका रानी, पीजीटी कॉमर्स फ्रॉम केंद्रीय विद्यालय बाद मथुरा। वी आर स्टार्टिंग द चैप्टर फाइनेंशियल मैनेजमेंट। वी आर स्टार्टिंग द टॉपिक फाइनेंशियल डिसीजन। इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव डिस्कस्ड देयर आर थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ फाइनेंशियल डिसीजन, इन्वेस्टिंग डिसीजन, फाइनेंसिंग डिसीजन एंड डिविडेंड डिसीजन। इन टूडेज वीडियो we will study the financing decisions to be taken by the financial manager, means from where the funds which are required by business organization, these funds are to be arranged. Financing decisions are what? It refers to the quantum of finance to be raised from various sources of long-term finance. It involves identification of various available sources. First of all, the managers will find out their requirement of the fund, how much fund is to be needed, and then from where that required fund is to be raised. Different sources are there. Sources are long-term sources and short-term sources. So from where the long-term finance are to be arranged, long-term funds are to be raised, that is the financing decision of the financial managers. Different sources are there to arrange long-term finance, that is shareholders fund and borrowed fund, or you can say owners fund and borrowed fund. Two types of sources are there, owners fund and borrowed fund. Owners fund, we know this includes equity, share capital and retained earning. In class 11th we have studied about it. And borrowed fund refers to the fund raised as debentures and other form of debt, means the fund which is arranged from the owners is called owners fund, means shareholders fund. It includes equity, share capital and retained earning. And the fund which is borrowed from the outsiders, the long term fund which is borrowed from the outsider, that is called borrowed fund. It includes debentures and loans and loans, long term loans taken from the financial institutions and commercial banks. So these, from these borrowed funds and shareholders fund, from where the long term finance is to be raised, which one is the better source, borrowed fund or the shareholder fund, this is decided in the financing decision. So factors affecting the financing decision of the financial managers before deciding about the fund should be raised from the borrowed fund and fund should be raised from the owner's fund, before deciding this, they should consider these factors. For example, a business need 50 lakh rupees to purchase a building. So from where this 50 lakh rupees is to be arranged? This 50 lakh rupees is to be arranged from the owner's fund, means from the equity share capital, or this 50 lakh rupees is to be arranged from the banks as loan, or it should be arranged by issuing debentures to the public. This is decided in financing decision. So first factor they will consider, that is cost. Means cost of raising fund is what? Cost of raising fund is different from the different sources. It is the amount of the cost of raising that fund is different from source to source. The prudent financial manager would normally opt for that source which is cheapest. If we see the cost of raising fund, cost of raising fund means the preliminary expenses which are to be incurred in raising fund, that is considered. So debts generally have less cost of raising fund. So the cost of raising fund is to be considered, and that source is to be selected which is having cheapest cost of raising fund. Second, risk is to be considered. How much risk is there? So owner's fund and borrowed fund, both are compared on the basis of this factor, risk, and that source is selected which is having less risk. And we all know, for a company, for a business organization, owner's fund are less risky because repayment obligations are not there. So risk element is also checked before selecting the fund for raising money. Flotation cost means फंड की रेजिंग कॉस्ट क्या है, फंड रेजिंग कॉस्ट क्या है. सो दैट कॉस्ट, दैट सोर्स ऑफ फंड इज़ टू बी सिलेक्टेड जिसका रेजिंग कॉस्ट कम से कम होगा. देन कैश फ्लो पोजिशन ऑफ द बिजनेस, बिजनेस इट सेल्फ इज़ हैविंग हाउ वट काइंड ऑफ कैश फ्लो पोजिशन. कैश फ्लोज मीन्स कैश इनफ्लोज एंड कैश आउटफ्लोज. दे विल चेक कैश इनफ्लोज आर मोर और कैश आउटफ्लोज आर मोर, और दे आर हैविंग फ्रीक्वेंट कैश इनफ्लोज और नॉट. मीन्स इट विल शो द लिक्विडिटी ऑफ द बिजनेस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. सो इफ देयर इज बैलेंस्ड कैश इनफ्लोज एंड आउटफ्लोज देन बिजनेस वुड बी कंसिडर्ड एज अ गुड बिजनेस विच इज एबल टू रीपे इट्स लाइबिलिटीज टाइमली. सो कैश फ्लो पोजिशन इज टू बी चेक्ड. अ स्ट्रॉगर कैश फ्लो पोजिशन make debt financing more. Means if business is having strong cash flow position, means business is able to pay its liabilities timely, then it will make that organization to be dependent on debt financing. Means they can arrange fund from debts in comparison to equity, because they would be able to repay their debts very easily if they have strong cash flow position. But if cash flow position is not very strong, it's very weak, means business is having cash crunch, business is not having sufficient cash to pay their liabilities in time, then they have to be dependent on owner's fund, because debt fund become more risky for them. Then the next is level of fixed operating cost. Fixed operating cost means how much rent they have to pay, how much insurance premium is to be paid, how much rent, how much salary, and how many other expenses are regularly paid by the business organization. If they are having more fixed operating cost, then business have to be less dependent on debt financing, because already they are having so many other expenditures for making payment. Then business will not be interested in increasing their operating cost by raising more debts. So if they are having already fixed high level of fixed operating cost, then business will be dependent on less debt financing. But if they are having less operating cost level is low, then business can obviously opt for debt financing, because it will give other benefits in the form of tax saving and increasing earning per share of the shareholders. This we will study later in the same chapter. Control consideration. What management want? They want to have keep control of that business organization in few hands, or they want to dilute their controlling powers. Dilution and control concentration are the two terms. Control concentration means few shareholders are having powers in their hand to control all the business organization. But if business will business is going to raise fund and they opt for equity or the equity share capital for raising that fund also, it will increase the number of shareholders. As number of shareholders will increases, it will give them voting powers also, and the power, controlling power of existing shareholder will be diluted among the new coming shareholders. So if a business is going to arrange more fund by more fund, and they are going to choose from where the fund is to be arranged, equity or the debt, so they have to consider their control consideration also. If management do not want to dilute their controlling powers to other shareholders, then they should opt for debt, because it will not give permit to other people to work as owner, because debt is collected as a borrowed fund. So those people who will give that borrowed fund to the business organization, they will not be having voting powers. So if they are ready to dilute their controlling powers, they can opt for equity. So issue of more equity shareholder may lead to dilution of management control over the business. जैसे ही वो ज़्यादा इक्विटी शेयर्स इश्यू करेंगे, ज़्यादा नंबर ऑफ शेयर होल्डर्स इंक्रीज़ हो जाएंगे, उतनी ही उनके पास वोटिंग पावर्स भी डाइल्यूट हो जाएंगी. बट इफ़ दे ऑप्ट फॉर डेट, देन नो सच काइंड ऑफ थिंग विल हैपन इन द बिजनेस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, एंड मैनेजर्स कैन कीप कंट्रोल ओवर द बिजनेस एक्टिविटीज. सो दे विल प्रेफर डेप्ट ऑन इक्विटी. देन स्टेट ऑफ कैपिटल मार्केट. वॉट इज़ द कैपिटल मार्केट स्टेट? कैपिटल मार्केट मे बी राइजिंग वेयर द प्राइस ऑफ द शेयर्स आर इंक्रीजिंग, इट मे बी डिप्रेस्ड वेयर द प्राइसेस ऑफ द शेयर फॉल्स. सो इफ द स्टॉक मार्केट इज राइजिंग देन मोस्ट ऑफ द पीपल वॉन्ट टू परचेज शेयर्स बिकॉज दे हैव दे थिंक दैट प्राइस ऑफ द शेयर्स आर इंक्रीजिंग. इफ दे इन्वेस्ट देयर मनी इन शेयर्स देयर प्राइस विल ऑल्सो बी इंक्रीज्ड एंड दे विल गेट बेनिफिट बिकॉज शेयर होल्डर्स वॉन्ट इंक्रीज इन द मार्केट प्राइस ऑफ द शेयर होल्ड शेयर्स. सो इफ द मार्केट प्राइस मार्केट इज राइजिंग मीन्स प्राइस ऑफ द शेयर्स इज इंक्रीजिंग देन ऑलमोस्ट इन्वेस्टर्स वॉन्ट टू इन्वेस्ट देयर मनी इन टू द शेयर्स. एंड इफ इट इज डिप्रेस्ड मार्केट वेयर द प्राइस ऑफ द शेयर्स आर फॉलिंग देन इट विल बी वेरी डिफिकल्ट फॉर द कंपनी टू रेज फंड फ्रॉम इक्विटी देन दे हैव टू प्रेफर डेट. सो दीज फैक्टर्स आर कंसिडर्ड बाय द बिजनेस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन बिफोर टेकिंग द फाइनेंशियल फाइनेंसिंग डिसीजन. सो फर्स्ट थिंग इज कॉस्ट. कॉस्ट ऑफ फंड इज वॉट, क्या कॉस्ट है फंड की, राइट, रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट क्या है एंड रेट ऑफ डिविडेंड क्या है, जिसका कम होगा दैट विल बी सेलेक्टेड. रिस्क, कितना रिस्क है उस फंड में, बोरोड फंड एंड डेट ओनर्स फंड दोनों में से कौन सा लेस रिस्की है दैट विल बी सेलेक्टेड. फ्लोटेशन कॉस्ट, फंड को रेज करने की कॉस्ट क्या है, जिसकी कम होगी दैट विल बी सिलेक्टेड. कैश फ्लो पोजिशन ऑफ द बिजनेस, अगर बिजनेस की खुद की कैश फ्लो पोजिशन मतलब कि कैश इज हैविंग कैश इज देयर इन द सफिशेंट अमाउंट टू पे द डेट्स एट राइट टाइम देन दे कैन प्रेफर डेट अदरवाइज इक्विटी. देन लेवल ऑफ ऑपरेटिंग कॉस्ट, अगर ऑपरेटिंग कॉस्ट ऑलरेडी हाई है देन दे विल प्रेफर इक्विटी. इफ इट इज़ ऑलरेडी लो, फिक्स्ड ऑपरेटिंग कॉस्ट इज लो देन दे कैन प्रेफर डेट. देन कंट्रोल कंसिडरेशन, इफ मैनेजमेंट वॉन्ट टू कंट्रोल ओवर द बिजनेस एक्टिविटीज दे विल प्रेफर डेट. डेट प्रेफर करने से क्या होगा, शेयर होल्डर्स इंक्रीज नहीं होंगे, वोटिंग पावर्स डायल्यूट नहीं होंगी एंड दे कैन इजीली कीप कंट्रोल ओवर द एक्टिविटीज ऑफ द कंपनी. एंड स्टेट ऑफ कैपिटल मार्केट, मार्केट इज राइजिंग देन दे विल प्रेफर डेट प्रेफर इक्विटी एंड इफ इट इज डिप्रेस्ड मार्केट देन दे विल प्रेफर डेट. थैंक यू, दैट्स ऑल फॉर टुडे. इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो वी विल स्टडी अबाउट डिविडेंड डिसीजन.